Welcome to the channel, well, welcome if you're welcome back or welcome for the first time. Subscribe if you haven't. There's a little button just underneath to subscribe. If you're unaware of it, this woman here is a MasterChef winner, I'll have you know. And we did a series.
Celebrity MasterChef,
because she's also a celebrity.
Well, no, I'm not saying that, because I'm saying it because I don't want people to think I'm an actual MasterChef.
Oh, I see. Oh, okay.
That would be presumptuous.
Oh, okay. So she's a celebrity MasterChef. She won. So food is important. We've made shows about food. You've written books about food.
Six books
about food. Food is a huge part of our lives. And I'm so hungry. It's ridiculous.
I just wanted to take
I haven't ordered mine yet. They don't order until a bit later. I haven't ordered anything, so you can have something. So this is a treat that I wanted to share with you, Nat. Films about food. There was the recent one with Stephen Graham, which was like a one take run through the restaurant. You weren't so keen on it.
I love Stephen Graham.
Yeah. But the food world and sort of poncy chefs and kind of flash chefs and all that kind of stuff. They can be real arseholes, can't they? Are many chefs arseholes?
Well, we made a whole show where I travelled around Europe cooking
for arsehole chefs.
Some of them were absolutely lovely.
Yeah, no,
some of them were total arseholes, violent, revolting arseholes.
I mean, really quite something.
I think, you know how they talk about, in our business, in show business, surgeons, these sorts of professions that attract psychopaths, and I think chefs is another one of the professions.
And of course you've got lots of knives and utensils, fire and boiling water, which you can play with.
This one quick kitchen we were filming in, a guy literally accidentally plunged his hand into boiling water and the chef wouldn't allow him to run it under cold water.
Do you remember that?
Screaming in pain.
So take that thought, have that thought, think of an exclusive island somewhere, a little bit like Johnny Depp's, with a flash restaurant on it.
I've got to keep my phone because my daughter's going.
No, but mine was going as well. Add into that certain cast members. Nicholas Hoult, who I think is
I love Nicholas Hoult.
He's a fabulous
he's
actor.
Brilliant.
Check him out as a malevolent bad guy in the Kelly Gang. It's a really great movie.
We finished watching that brilliant series.
Catherine
the Great.
Catherine,
We watched it. We watched 2 episodes, thought it was genius.
Brilliant, and then stopped. And we then, do that with so much. We,
no, you did it.
You
do
it.
Never do
you
that.
Stop.
Where you just go, you suddenly stop watching something that you love. It's really
it's
strange.
It's like restrictive eating. It's really, really strange. So Nicholas Hoult's in here. Anya Taylor-Joy is in here.
Brilliant actress.
Who we love. And Ralph Fiennes is in
here. Wow, what a cast.
And Ralph Fiennes, I think, has a little bit too much fun with this part. So let's check it out, shall we? It's called The Menu.
I haven't heard anything about it.
No, I know. And I've kind of hunted around and I knew this was coming because I'd mentioned it on the Weekly Rushes. But yeah, check this out.
Oh, this is like that
good
chef.
Evening.
The Swiss chef.
Welcome to Hawthorne. It'll be our pleasure to feed you.
Oh my God.
Tonight we'll be magical.
Over the next few hours, you will ingest fat, salt, protein,
dairy,
and at times entire ecosystems.
We're eating the ocean.
Oh, it's we're eating the ocean.
Are you crying?
It's just I find it all very moving.
So it's okay that I'm not as into this as you are.
Oh my God!
You shouldn't be here tonight. You, my dear guests, are not the common man. Isn't that right?
Yes, sir!
Is he gonna keep doing that?
What happens inside this room is meaningless compared to what happens outside.
Yes, sir!
We are but a frightened nanosecond.
Yes, sir!
Nature is timeless.
Yes, sir!
What the hell is going on?
Yes, sir!
I love you all.
Yes, sir! We love you too, sir!
Any questions?
Is this bergamot I'm getting, chef?
Yes, it is.
Wow. Do you know what I was getting real vibes of? Guess what I was getting vibes of? A series we saw recently and we had to bail out.
Oh. It was reminding
Nicole
me a bit.
Nicole Kidman.
Oh, were you? I was getting vibes of The Platform, that film on...
Oh, don't talk to me about that travel film. It's disgusting.
What, the way they have the food going down through
Why
the different layers?
Why do we have people dying on the food? It was horrible.
It was a brilliant film about social class.
I don't know. It's unnecessary.
So it was reminding you of, what was it, Nine Good Friends or something? Or Nine something like that? Well, Perfect Strangers.
Even the music,
quite the opposite.
Even the music was this Nine Perfect Friends. Even the music was the same. The sliding doors.
What's going on? What's outside?
I don't really care, actually. I was looking at the duck. I was thinking, oh, I wonder how they're going to get into that duck with those scissors.
What is that? He's just like the chef on the Amalfi Coast. He would clap.
Everyone
would go, yes, chef.
Yes, chef.
Just like that. And
they moved in unison, but he was lovely, that head chef.
Oh, he was
I really
lovely.
Liked him.
No, he
and
was
it
really
was
nice.
The most sensational. Can you please take me back to... I want to stay in that hotel because we were filming in it, so we were like the plebs. Can you please take me to that hotel one day as a romantic surprise and just say, guess what? We're going to the hotel where they have tomatoes as decoration. The ceiling
was
inside is real tomato, the most gorgeous tomatoes.
Yeah.
The food, every mouthful you take.
You don't have to order a tomato salad. Yeah. You just go like this.
It's where Jamie Oliver had his honeymoon. No, he had his honeymoon there. But the food was out of this world.
We've gone off on food. So what did you think of that? Do you want to see that?
Of course I want to see
it. But isn't it a bit horrific
for you? I don't really
want
to go outside.
It's the horror.
I don't want to know what's going on outside with the wings and everything.
I think Ralph Fiennes is going to relish
and
that.
I want to see the relationships at the table. Yeah. And I want to see... But whatever the monster is, or whatever the moral of the story is...
Have you ever cooked with bergamot?
Well, bergamot is in Earl Grey tea. And I have steamed a duck breast with Earl Grey tea. Bit of wank, really. If you ask me, just crispy skin.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of Earl Grey, and I don't think I'm a fan of bergamot.